And then it was just popping from like 10 p.m. to 3 a.m. The place was packed. And then we got that third wave of people coming through, because it was all the waitresses, all the servers getting off work at 3-4 in the morning and coming to hang out with us as the after party. So like the other shows in the festival, you know, had rational start times at 7, 8, 9 p.m. And then when people would let out of those audiences would come over to us for the after party, and those comics would come over to us. And so yeah, we'd be rocking till like 2-3 in the morning. And then what would happen, it wasn't open micers, it was like the locals, the hardcore locals, and then the people in the lineup who really wanted to be there would take over. And so there were a few comics and who kind of ran the show from 4 in the morning till 6 in the morning, and they called that the Stinkhole hour. And it really turned into a cult very fast. Right. It was so crazy, the support, like waitresses at Danny's, the comedy club there.
I was wondering when he was going to hit a dead spot with the Wi-Fi, because he's out in you just hit a dead spot, and I was wondering sooner or later you had to, wherever you are up in the high desert there.